No, you don't.
You do.
No, you don't.
You gotta die one day.
No, you will die. But you want to have a personal relationship with God before you die. Any wise man should know that. If indeed you call yourself a wise man, you need to know that God will judge you. Why don't you have a personal relationship with Him right now? Why don't you confess your sins to Him right now? Why don't you call Him your friend right now? That would be wise. Today is your day, because tomorrow may not be yours. Tomorrow belongs to Jesus, not to men. It doesn't matter how strong you are. It doesn't matter how powerful you think you are. Let me tell you, the Bible says in Revelation chapter 1 verse 18, Jesus has the key of life. He has the key, the keys of death. Now, if you are to die today without making peace with Jesus, it is hell until judgment day. And when Jesus comes for the second time, Jesus will judge you and says to you, go to the left, go to the left. That's where you belong, go to the left. Go to the devil, because when you go to the right, you go to Jesus. You go to the everlasting peace. But when you go to the left, you go to the lake of fire. That's what the Bible says. If you think I'm lying, read Matthew 25. Everything is in the book. I know so many of you have a Bible at home. So many people have a Bible at home. They spend so much time watching TV, and they don't know that they are one breath away to the grave. They don't know that. They spend so much time in their smartphone. Nowadays, you see people all over the place with a smartphone. They're searching. They don't know what they're searching for. They're flipping. They don't know what they're looking for. But if only you would take the time to say, Lord Jesus, you woke me up this morning. I want to spend some time with you. I want to thank you for waking me up this morning. Because every morning you wake me up. But now it's time for me to spend some time with you. What would you want me to do to please you? You see, it is possible for you to have a personal conversation with God. If I can have a personal relationship with God, so can you. If God can speak to me, God can speak to you too. All you need to do is to put your pride aside. Hello? Humble yourself. Just like the Bible says in 2 Chronicles chapter 7, verse 14. If my people who are called by my name would humble themselves and pray, that's all you need to do, is to surrender your life to God. Because God has no business with those who are so prideful. He has no business with them. But if you would humble yourself before God, God would receive you. Hello? This is your spiritual breakfast today. This is your lunch today on your way. Remember that the Lord Jesus Christ is coming back.
Amen.
Don't ever forget that. Because He is from everlasting to everlasting. He is the God of the world. He is the God of the universe. He is the God of every creature, especially mankind. God created mankind in His image. In order to have a personal relationship with men, we have turned our backs on God. God is angry today with the world. God wants you to make a U-turn and follow Him. What a beautiful day. What a beautiful day.
Some people don't like the gospel.
It's a shame.
But the Bible says that God loves the feet of them that carry the great tidings, the good tidings.
And the good tidings is that Jesus Christ suffered and died. According to the scripture.
And he was buried.
And he arose again the third day according to the scripture.
I want to tell you what you can do according to the scripture.
The wages of sin is death.
That's what you can do.
You can die. You can do very good at dying.
Danielle, town.
And the fact is that you are sinners. Oh, I'm not a sinner. When you're in the ground dead, you're a sinner, because the Bible says we all have sinned, and the wages of sin is death. But that verse goes on.